welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Funken Dolly. Today I'm going to be telling you about the time that I was homeless in Dubai. I've had my fair share of experiences since I moved over here, and today I'm going to be telling you guys about that in particular. So I think this happened sometime in March when my husband and I, we were kicked out of our apartment literally. So this is what happened. We paid our house rent to the subletter who rented the entire apartment from the owner who doesn't live in Dubai, apparently. So we paid our house rent, but the subletter had not renewed his contract with the owner of the apartment, and we were not even aware of it. We thought we were dealing with the owner of the apartment, you know. So we got up that morning. I think I went to work, my husband was at home, and then along the course of the day, he texts me like, oh, there's a problem. The owner of the apartment is here telling us we need to move out. I'm like, what are you talking about? What owner of the apartment? I thought you paid the rent and everything. He's like, yeah, he paid the rent, but okay, give me a couple of minutes, I'll be right back. I'm like, okay. In my head, it was some sort of a joke, or I didn't really know what was happening. So my husband calls me later on telling me there's a serious problem. I'm like, what's going on? He tells me, okay, the person you know to whom we always pay our rents, that's not the owner of the apartment. I'm like, okay. So he says, oh yeah, so the owner of the apartment is here and he does not know us. One, we've never paid any rents to him. Two, he's asking us where the subletter is, who is the guy we pay our rents to. I'm like, what is going on? What are you talking about? Subletter, owner? He's like, just listen to me. I'm like, okay. So bottom line, what was happening was the owner had come, he was coming to renew his contract with the subletter, and he expected to meet the subletter in the apartment with his family. Apparently the subletter had lied to the owner that he wants to move into the entire apartment of 3 rooms with his family, you know, kitchen and 3 rooms, and the owner had rented out his apartment to this guy. This guy took this apartment and rented it out to different people, like different couples, my husband and I, and then we had an Indian British couple, and then we had, I don't know, I really can't remember the nationality that occupied the 3rd room, but yeah, so he rented out to 3 different people. So when the owner came, he was confused and amazed, like, why is he seeing different faces in his apartment? What the hell is going on? That's when my husband understood that, oh, okay, there's actually a problem. Everybody tried contacting the subletter. He wouldn't pick up his phone. At some point, his number wasn't going through at all. To make matters worse, the owner was so pissed off. Like, he's very angry. He does not know us. As a matter of fact, he's calling the police into this story. Whoa, whoa, whoa. That's when I was like, police, like, what have we done? No, we are innocent. Like, we've not done anything. He's like, he's giving us 24 hours to pack out. Like, if we don't pack out, the police is going to be here the next day. And as a matter of fact, as he was leaving our apartment, he was going to the electricity company and the water company for them to cut our contract, like to provide us water. Like, on that same day, we're not going to have water anymore, we're not going to have electricity anymore, and we're not going to have gas. I was like, wow, this is serious. Sincerely, I thought I was like, okay, when I come home, maybe I'll go talk to this owner, you know, as a woman, explain to him, like, please give us time, give us 2 weeks or so, because that was mid-month when all of these things were happening, when all of this chaos was happening. I was like, I'll come home, I'll go talk to him with the other lady, Kim, yeah, that was living in the other room. We would go as women to just plead, like, give us till the end of the month and we'll move out. My husband was like, no, he doesn't want to talk to anybody and he's leaving, and he says to the next day he's coming over with the police. On getting home, I believed that there was going to be a solution, but when I got home, the two other couples were literally packing out. I was like, wait a minute, so is this thing for real? Is this happening? They're like, yes, that is happening. There's no gas anymore. There's no internet. As a matter of fact, there's no water. They cannot even spend the night here. How do they take a bath to go to work the next day? Oh my God, that's when it dawned on me that I'm homeless in Dubai and I'm stranded. Wow, I had to call my husband. He came, he was not around, my husband was not around, but he had to rush back home for us to find the solution. Luckily for us, there was an empty apartment, like a new empty apartment on the same floor of our building, because what we lived, like the building was like a 60 something story building, so there was another room. We had to move our furniture that night, we had to move everything, and of course we had lost the money we had paid to the subletter. We had paid him caution money apart, like caution, we had paid him rent. We lost all of that because nobody could get hold of him. We had to move into that other room, into that other apartment that same night, and pay house rent again, because the owner of that apartment was like, but you guys have to pay me money before you guys can live in my apartment, even if it's just for the next 2 weeks before the month end, and you guys move out and look for another space or apartment or house, whatever. That same night we had to pay some amount of money to the owner of this new apartment. We went to bed at about 1 a.m. I will check my phone if I still have a couple of pictures, because those are just painful life experiences that happened to me, and in my mind I was like, I need to keep memories about this, like, you know, to just look back at some point when I'm living in my cozy, be it 20 bedroom house or 15 bedroom house in the future, I look back at my journey, I'm like, you've had your fair share of life, girl. So
now, yeah,
paid I'll check. If I find pictures or just short videos, I will attach to this video. But yeah, we spent the night, we went to bed that day at about 1 a.m., 2 a.m. We had to literally put our mattress like on the floor. Everybody was too tired. Please, nobody had time to mount the bed, do everything for the apartment to look nice. We just needed to sleep. So after that, yeah, after I think it took us about 2-3 days for us to set up like this new room and everything, you know. And eventually after 2 weeks, at the end of the month, we moved out of that apartment because the owner was not the easiest person to deal with as well. He was being very complicated, and it was also very expensive because he saw that we were stranded, like we really really needed accommodation. So yeah, after that we moved out, and that's when we found this apartment, this room, and yeah, since then we've been comfortable, like we are settling in and everything. But yeah, for a day in Dubai, we were literally homeless, we were stranded. Seriously, some situations you don't know if you have to cry, if you don't even know how to feel and everything. But yeah, so I just thought I'd share this experience with you guys. Lessons did I learn? Before I pay any house rent or any deposit or anything to anybody, one, I need proof to show me that you own the apartment. That's the first thing. Two, I need a receipt, because the mistake we did was we trusted this guy so much, we weren't even collecting no receipts for the payments we were making, you know. I need a receipt, so if we have to sue him or take him to the police, we'll have proof that we paid this money to this guy by this name, and now this is what has happened to us. So if you intend to come to Dubai, or if this kind of thing ever happens to you, or in case you're even already based in Dubai but you pay your rent and you don't collect no receipts, please make sure you do, as from now on, just to avoid complicated scenarios like this. So yeah, that's the end of this story time that I wanted to share with you guys. I have a whole lot of things that have happened to me since I moved into this country. With time, I will share with you guys. But yeah, so that's it. We are happy, we are comfortable now, so that's what matters. To God be the glory. So that's the end of this video, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to click that subscribe button. Bye.